This was the scene earlier when Saad Hariri, along with his wife and eldest son, bid farewell to Emmanuel Macron and his wife. The group had lunch to discuss the political crisis swirling around Hariri, a crisis Macron hopes to have calmed with his visit. Here is how we got to this point. Hariri abruptly resigned on November 4th while in Saudi Arabia. He claimed he fled over fear for his life, sensing an assassination attempt from Iran. But many observers concluded the Saudis were forcing him to step down. His resignation plunged Lebanon into a political crisis. Lebanon's president accused Saudi Arabia of holding Hariri against his will, something Hariri and the Saudis deny. Fawaz Jurgis has been watching the developments closely. He is the chair of Contemporary Middle Eastern Studies at the London School of Economics. Hello, Fawaz. I just want to begin by letting you know about the latest wire that's moved, where France is considering hosting a meeting with the International Lebanon Support Group to figure out how this crisis should move forward in Lebanon. And I think the question for many folks is, why is France stepping forward to try and mediate in this crisis?
Well, I mean, it's a very good question. Al-Hariri family is a multi-billionaire family. It has had very close relations with France for the past 30 years. France basically created modern Lebanon in the 1920s and 1930s. France and Lebanon have very close relations economically and culturally. France is very much concerned about political and economic stability in Lebanon. And the French leadership, particularly President Macron, feels that Lebanon might have reached a turning point. So what the French leadership, what President Macron is trying to do, is to basically try to mediate, to mediate between Al-Hariri and the president of Lebanon, also try to mediate between Saudi Arabia and Lebanon, and to make sure that the geostrategic rivalry between Saudi Arabia, Sunni-dominated Saudi Arabia, and Shia-dominated Iran does not really play out on Lebanon's street, because Lebanon is deeply divided along, you know, pro-Saudi and pro-Iranian. And there is no better country, more qualified country, than France to really try to prevent Lebanon from plunging into all-out war.
Well, if Lebanon is on such unstable ground, why is Hariri saying that he wants to go back to Lebanon? He said that his life is in danger, that Hezbollah has destabilized the country, and he's a Saudi national. His children are now attending school in Saudi Arabia. Why would he go back?
Well, first of all, because the Lebanese constitution stipulates that the prime minister must basically offer his resignation to the president of Lebanon. It's a presidential system. And everyone in Lebanon has been calling on Prime Minister Hariri to return home. There's really the entire country has rallied around Prime Minister Al-Hariri. He has become a unifying figure. Many Lebanese now are anxious about the situation. They're terrified that political instability could really basically pour gasoline on the raging fire. As you know, there are wars in Iraq, in Syria, in Yemen, in Libya. And Lebanon has escaped the reverberations of the neighboring Syrian conflict. So many Lebanese would like the prime minister to return home and to engage in political negotiations with the leadership, the president, and the various political groups in order to resolve the crisis. So the prime minister has promised to return to Lebanon on Wednesday. Ironically, Wednesday is the Independence Day for Lebanon, independence from France, because France was the colonial power. So there are many ironies in President Macron's hosting Prime Minister Al-Hariri today. One point very important for your own viewers. The French president has insisted on welcoming Saad Al-Hariri as the Prime Minister of Lebanon, because he read his resignation statement from Saudi Arabia. And the President of Lebanon said that's unacceptable. The Constitution says he has to basically talk to the President first. So President Macron said the Prime Minister of Lebanon, he very welcoming and warm welcome. And I think my take on it is that the French leadership hopes that the Prime Minister, when he goes to Lebanon, he will take back his resignation. because I think there is now, as I've said earlier, there's a kind of really the Lebanese political establishment would like to listen to what al-Hariri has to say and try to meet some of his conditions, if that's possible.
Fawaz, let me jump in because we only have time for one more question, and it's the bigger picture. While we're talking individually about Hariri meeting with Macron, this is a much larger development in terms of regional stability. Is this Saudi Arabia cleaning house in the Middle East, or is this the beginning of something much more serious and brutal?
I mean, I think this is a very important question because Lebanon is part of a larger and broader new Cold War between Saudi Arabia and Iran. This Cold War has been playing out on Arab streets for almost 10, 15 years in Iraq, in Bahrain, in Lebanon, in Syria, in Yemen. It's now escalating, it's heating up. And Saudi Arabia now is trying to stand up and confront Iranian influence. Iran has become an unrivaled superpower in the Middle East. It's the most dominant power in Iraq, in Lebanon, in Syria. I mean, Iran has almost won in Syria and has tremendous influence in Yemen. So what Saudi Arabia is trying to do now is to go to really lead from the front, in particular because the American President Trump has given, obviously, the green light to the Saudi leadership, because also President Trump is very much anti-Iran, and he has made it very clear that Iran is a rogue state, is a troublemaker, and is supporting terrorist groups. So what you're seeing here is probably the establishment, the beginning, we're seeing the beginning of a regional and international coalition led by the United States, but spearheaded by Saudi Arabia and its allies. And the French are terrified that Lebanon now is a new battlefield in this raging regional geostrategic rivalry between Sunni-dominated Saudi Arabia and Shia-dominated Iran. This could really destroy Lebanon as we know it, because it's a very fragile, as you've said, very fragile country indeed.